Good morning. I'm Sridevi, Department of Computer Science. In this session, we are going to discuss about software testing. Software testing is a process of executing a program with the intent of finding the software bug. Software testing is part of a group of activities called verification and validation that are involved in software quality assurance. Validation and verification. What is meant by verification? Are we building the product right? That is verification. Here, the specification is tested with the code. The set of activities that ensure that software correctly implements a specific function or algorithm. Validation means, are we building the right product? The specification reflects what it should. Here, the set of activities that ensure that the software has been built is traceable to customer requirements. Software testing includes the following testing: unit testing, integration testing, validation testing, and system testing. Unit testing. Unit testing focuses on component or module, that is smallest unit. Unit test is white box oriented. What are the considerations of unit testing? Module interface, tester to ensure the information flow, local data structures, boundary conditions, all independent path and control structures. Finally, all error handling paths are tested by using test cases. So what are the common errors in computations means in unit testing? Incorrect arithmetic precedence, mixed mode operation, incorrect initialization, precision inaccuracy, incorrect symbolic representation. Those are the common errors in computation. The next, test cases should uncover errors such as data types, logical operator, comparison of variables, then improper loop termination, iteration, and loop variables. Unit testing is an assistant to the coding step. Here, the source code developed can be reviewed and verified for the component level design, and then unit test case begins. Unit test case environment includes driver and stub. Driver is the main program. Stub uses the subordinate modules interface. Unit testing is simplified when a component with high cohesion. The next one, integration testing. Integration means putting them together. It is a systematic technique for constructing the program structure. Two approaches are there. The first one is incremental integration testing, and then second one is non-incremental integration testing. Non-incremental integration testing. That testing is constructed using Big Bang approach. Here all the components are combined in advance. The entire program is tested as a whole. Set of errors encountered in that area, the correction is difficult. Incremental integration testing. It is constructed and tested in small increments. Errors are easier to isolate and correct. Three kinds of integration testing are top-down integration, bottom-up integration, sandwich integration. Top-down integration. Modules are integrated by moving downwards, either a depth first or breadth first manner. Top down verifies major control early in the test process. Decision making occurs at upper levels. In depth first, complete function of the software may be implemented. The next one is bottom up integration. Bottom up integration begins construction and testing with atomic modules, that is component at the lower level. Low level components are combined into clusters. Driver modules need to be built to test the lower level modules. The next one is sandwich integration. Sandwich integration is nothing but combination of both top down and bottom up integration. Integration move upward needs separate test drivers. Top-down drivers can be reduced. When integration for a certain functional group is complete, integration and testing moves on to the next group. Regression testing. Regression testing is the re-execution of some subset of test. that have already been conducted to ensure the changes have not propagated side effects. After that regression testing, we ensure that changes do not introduce additional errors. During the modules are combined, there may be some changes are occur. That particular changes do not introduce additional errors. Regression testing conducted by manually or by using automated tool. The next one, smoke testing. Smoke testing is one of the integration testing approach used when shrink-wrapped software products are being developed. Smoke testing designed for time-critical projects on a frequent basis. Here, the software components translated into code that is called build. Build includes all data files, libraries, reusable modules, and engineered components. Series of tests is designed to expose errors that will keep build from properly performing its function. Build is integrated with other builds. Smoke test should exercise the entire system. What are the benefits of smoke testing? Here, the integration risk is minimized and the quality of the end product is improved. Error diagnosis and corrections are simplified with the new software increments. Progress is easier to assess. Validation testing. Final series of software testing is validation testing. What are the criteria in validation testing? Validation is achieved through a series of black box testing. Here, test plan and test procedures are used. Test plan, classes of tests to be conducted. Test procedure means the procedure defines specific test cases. Here, both plan and procedure ensure all functional requirements are satisfied. Functional requirements means transportability, compatibility, error recovery, maintainability. A configuration review, that means auditing will be conducted and important to ensure all elements of software have been properly developed. Here, alpha and beta testing are conducted. Acceptance test conducted by end user, not software engineer. Conducted over a period of weeks or months. Software builders use a process called alpha and beta testing to uncover errors. Alpha testing conducted at a developer site by a customer. Beta testing is conducted at one or more customer sites by the end user of software. The end user records all problems that are encountered and reports these to the developers at regular intervals. System testing. System testing includes the following testing: recovery testing, security testing, stress testing, performance testing. Recovery testing. Recovery testing is a system that forces the software to fail in a variety of ways and verifies that recovery is properly performed, whether it is automatic or human intervention. Then security testing. Security testing avoids illegal problems, example hackers. Security testing checking protection mechanism by using flank or rear attack. The next one, stress testing. Stress testing executing a system in a manner that demands resources in abnormal quantity, frequency or volume. Example, interrupt, IO interrupt, maximum memory resources utilization, virtual OS. Performance testing. Performance testing is used to test the runtime performance of software, and performance of an individual module may be tested with the white box testing. Performance testing is to measure resource utilization, and it uncovers situations that lead to degradation and possible system failure.